one all the way down here again. Thank you.
My dad used to watch wrestling, and that was kind of our thing together. So when WWE approached me at 19, my dad was like, just so excited. Like he couldn't believe it. He's like, I'm watching, you know, something we did together, and now you're living it. So he was just the best. Before I got signed to WWE, I was going to college for broadcast journalism. I was 6 months in, and I knew I didn't really want to be there. Like, I was like, what do I want to do? I want to perform. I want to be in front of people. I didn't know what I wanted to do. Kind of was doing some modeling on the side while I was going to college, and I got a phone call from WWE. They called my manager, and then my manager called me, and he was like, hey, so WWE like really likes your look. Would you be interested? And I said, of course. Like, that's so cool. I never knew how to get into it. I'm gonna prove to them I'm not just this little model. And I got a phone call from Paul Heyman. They were just starting up ECW. And he was like, hey, so we have this part. So what it is you're gonna like go and kind of do a little strip tease, and then your jealous boyfriend is gonna come and cover you up. I was like, let me just go with it. And I finally got comfortable after a few months, and then we did Extreme Exposé. I got really close to Layla and Brooke, and that was fun. Like, it was different than anybody was kind of doing at the time there. And we got to do that and perform, and we were on every week, so that was really cool. And, you know, and getting to travel with these people and getting so close, they were like my family. I remember my first match was against Ariel, and she was like the vampire on ECW. It was like a year after I had been training, I finally was like, okay, I'm able to wrestle.
The X factor here, in my opinion, is Kelly Kelly. I mean, don't get me wrong, I can't wait to see Kelly get in there and have at it, as they say.
I remember when I was in ECW, they would constantly bring me to Raw and have me go and perform on Raw. And so it was kind of like a slow kind of moving process. And I was so happy that I started at ECW, because I was kind of thrown to the wolves. And so I was built, you know, kind of built a thick skin. So going to Raw and like performing for bigger, I was like, oh, I got this. You know, I can do this. And I loved it. I loved Raw. And then I got moved to SmackDown and back and forth for a few years. And then getting to perform for the troops over in Iraq and Afghanistan. I was 20 when I first went over there. And that was one of the most rewarding experiences, to go over there and perform for the troops. You know, so I was trying to mentally prepare myself for that. And I remember I would walk in, and I was so happy. And because I was so thankful for everything they had done. And I was so honored to be there. And in 2011, it was me, Beth Phoenix, and Eve, and we were going against Brie Bella. And the fans had to vote who they wanted to see go against Brie.
This one's up to you. You get to choose the stipulations. You get to choose the matches. Make sure you use your cell phones tonight. This one is your call.
And so I ended up winning. But it was so nerve-wracking, because we didn't know. We legit were backstage, and we were like, okay, it's... And as soon as the, you know, the answer hit to whoever, you had to walk right out through the curtain and just steal your match.
Introducing the challenger from Jacksonville, Florida, Kelly Kelly!
After I won, I was just like, oh my, I started crying. I was just like, it was like I worked for so many years to finally get to this moment, and everybody had kind of recognized how hard I worked, and because it wasn't handed to me. It was years of practice and years of hard work, and it was like all those years of proving people wrong that I'm not just a model and that I belong here.
This right here, Cole, is a great moment for Kelly Kelly. This guy started right here with all your guns.
Congratulations to our new Divas Champion, Kelly Kelly!
Oh, congratulations. You must be loving Power to the People right now, huh?
I am. Thank you guys so much for voting for me tonight. This is my first ever Divas Championship, and I'm so excited. I promise to make everybody so proud, and thank you guys. I can't thank you enough. It really does prove Power to the People.
When I retired in 2013, I had been here in WWE for 7 years, and I had never had any injuries. I had never taken any time off. So I was on the road consistently every week. And I think I was just kind of like ready to kind of take some time. I was still very young. I was 25. I hadn't really had any life experiences. I was kind of thrown into this at 19, and I got to travel the world, which and perform for millions of fans. How many 19-year-olds get to say that? they got to do that. And I just wanted to be at home and I just wanted to try something new. I wanted to get into acting more. And, you know, I went to Hunter and he was like, look, the door's always open. And so he was like, just know that, you know, we're always here and whenever you want to come back.
I need to see how it looks.
Perfect, right? Looks great.
Yeah, it looks really good. Yeah, it looks good. Yeah. Should we do another walk through?
Let's see how it looks this way. Yeah, that looks great.
I was on WAGS and Instagram was really blowing up and I was like, I gotta be a part of this. And you know, these brands started reaching out and they were like, we'd love to for you to be an ambassador. I made a career out of posting my fashion and what I wear every day. I just started, you know, shooting, you know, doing Selva and stuff like that and just doing like my clothing and like my everyday wear and my fashion, you know, affordable fashion basically. I work with like some really big brands now on social media, like Pretty Little Thing, Fashion Nova, shoe brands now will reach out, Reebok has just reached out. So you just don't know who you're gonna hit and you just kind of start posting and you just start tagging people because you're wearing their stuff and then they'll see that. And so I've been very lucky when it comes to the brands who I work with. I'm gonna do a line of wine. I'm starting with a rosé. These are my wines. I mean, this is the first wine that I'm coming out with. So Smith & Devereaux is the winery in Napa that I've been working with. And so these are the other red wines. But right now, the rosé is the main focus.
On October 28th, over 50 women, then, now, and forever, will participate in an event called Evolution.
Looking back, 12 years ago, never did I ever think women would have their own pay-per-view. I was just so honored to be a part of it. And I just, even in, you know, 5 years, right before I left, I still couldn't imagine. And so when I left and seeing how much progress that the women have had and how much impact and, you know, the girls are going out there and they're just killing it. They're having 20-minute matches on the, we're only given 5 minutes to go out there. And I feel like girls were given so much more time. And so Evolution was such an honor to be a part of. I'm a co-founder in this charity, the startup nonprofit charity called CureGlioblastoma.org. And it's a cancer, it's a brain cancer that I lost my father of. It took him from when he got diagnosed to when he passed was like 2 months. I truly believe in this charity and it's something that's so close to my heart. And, you know, I'm like, I'm dropping everything to do this because I want to honor my father and I, you know. So yeah, it's, you know, such a great charity and I think it's gonna help a lot of families. I think he would just be so, so proud and so happy and to see what I've done and how I can honor him. And he's only wanted, you know, he's always supported me and he was, he was like my biggest fan, so. I just want to do anything that I can now to kind of honor him and make him proud. And, you know, he's looking down, you know, just seeing how well and how, you know, I always just want to honor him and make him happy and proud. And so now that's what I'm doing. So I got the call about the Raw reunion and I was like, of course, I'll be there.
Congratulations!
Oh, I'm so excited!
Great to see you!
One, two, three, that's it!
If it wasn't for the fans and, you know, having them have my back and always kind of be on my side and especially with, like, you know, little girls when they would come up and say, you know, I want to be just like you. Now, looking back, I loved my career. I wouldn't change a thing about it. I was just so lucky and I loved what I did. I had so much fun. I met amazing people. I really grew up. I grew up and I figured out what I want in life and what I want to do. The WWE Universe has not seen the last of Kelly. I will be around for a very long time.